And this is why conventional politics, as it is practiced in the United States today, bothers me, no matter almost who the politician is, unless the politician in question is directly challenging the political system we operate in, they're going to disappoint and disillusion, and you know, ultimately we have to think about how much to trust them. And unfortunately, the example I have to draw from this week, unfortunately, because he's popular, very, very popular among Democrats, certainly. Unfortunately, this week's example, and I'm going to have one every week, this week's example is Barack Obama. Barack Obama was a surprise motivational speaker for an executive retreat for Boeing Incorporated last month. Now, Boeing Incorporated, of course, is one of the biggest defense contractors out there. So its relationships are inherently political and inherently militaristic in nature. And one of the, he waived his usual fee, which is considerable. For example, he got, I believe, $450,000 to speak to a hedge fund investment firm, a Wall Street firm, Cantor Fitzgerald, last year. But in this case, he waived the fee because he got a $10 million contribution from Boeing for his library and museum in Chicago. Now, these libraries and museums have been a way, and foundations and so on, have led other former presidents down the primrose path, ethically speaking, before. I would argue that Bill Clinton has made the same mistake. Now, the Obama Foundation refused to confirm that report of $10 million, but the group's website does say that Boeing gave more than $1 million. I think when you start dealing with defense contractors, government contractors, military firms in the millions of dollars for foundations, which, by the way, also incurs millions of dollars of tax breaks, you're really talking about operating at a stratospheric level of economic and political power that divorces our leaders from what democracy is supposed to represent, which is we, the people.